It is something almost everyone has experienced in their lives, train delays. They are an inconvenience, making you arrive late at school, work, family visits, or whatsoever. What people do not realize is that there is much more to a train delay than it seems. As a start, a train delay is caused by some sort of failure or error. However, solving this and dealing with the consequences, it is a complex interaction between different fields. For example, look at the case of a failing switch. A failure happens when a crucial component of the switch is not operating the way it is supposed to be. This will limit train capacity on a track, often resulting in delays. These delays will result in trains not being where they are supposed to be, so direct corrections in the operations are needed to keep the rest of the system functioning as normal. Due to the problems, passenger flows will be disrupted, which can result in problems at stations. While all this is happening, repairs need to be made, which means people and materials have to be able to reach the defected part. In some cases, repairs can even further reduce availability of the track, thus providing an extra challenge in the operations. The ease with such a repair can take place is also depending on the design. Some designs allow easy repairs, while others design make repairs far more complex. In the ideal case, a sudden failure of a switch does not often take place due to good inspection and maintenance. All aspects seen in this example will be discussed in this MOOC. Also, the interdependency of all the choices made will be shown. You will experience this firsthand while playing the specially designed railway game. In the first week of this MOOC, we will be focusing on the technical background of the rail system. Details of both trains and tracks will be discussed, looking at how they are designed to work together as a complete system. In the second week, we will continue with the human aspects of railways. In this week, the focus will be on all human interactions with the system. Of course, stations will be discussed here and their complex design to make sure there is an efficient passenger flow, but also the effects of tracks and the surrounding residents will be introduced. The third week will focus on the control of railways. In this week, you will learn how control systems work and how this influences the amount of trains that can run on a track. Also, timetabling will be introduced. Now that all aspects of the system in healthy condition have been introduced, week 4 will introduce what happens when things do not go as planned. It will not only focus on what can go wrong, but as well on how to act in case things do go wrong to limit the impact as much as possible. Week 5 will introduce the complex relation between monitoring and maintenance. It will show what decisions can be made about reliability of the system, but also look at what can be done to balance reliability of the system and costs of maintenance. After these 5 weeks containing the essentials of railway engineering, the last week will give you a peek into the future of railways.